Functions of the cerebellum. Functional division of the cerebellum includes vestibulocerebellum, spinocerebellum, and corticocerebellum. First of all, we are going to see the control of body posture and equilibrium. It's a function of vestibulocerebellum. Afferents of the vestibulocerebellum. Vestibulocerebellar tract, it conveys static equilibrium from macula of saccule and utricle via vestibular nuclei and kinetic equilibrium from ampullary crest of semicircular ducts. Spinocerebellar and cuneocerebellar tract. This tract carry information related to muscle tone and position of limb in the space. Reticulocerebellar tract brings feedback about activities of extrapyramidal system. Efferents from floculonodular lobe and fastigial nuclei go to spinal cord through vestibular and reticular nuclei via vestibulospinal and reticulospinal tract. Efferents via vestibular nuclei and reticular nuclei influence spinal motor neurons to keep body posture upright. And via medial longitudinal fasciculus, which connects motor nuclei of extraocular muscles and regulate the position of eyes in relation to movements of head. Control of muscle tone and stretch reflexes. It's a function of spinocerebellum. Afferents from spinocerebellar, cuneocerebellar, and olivocerebellar tract carry feedback from proprioceptive and tactile receptors. It gives information about muscle tone and position of limbs and body. Spinocerebellum receives auditory and visual information via tactocerebellar tract. It also receives cortical inputs via pons nuclei. Efferents coming out of the spinocerebellum from nuclei fastigiae, nuclei emboli, and nuclei globosus via fastigio-bulbar, cerebelloreticular, and cerebellooliary tracts. Via reticulospinal and olivospinal tracts, it reaches to alpha and gamma motor neurons of the spinal cord. Through this pathway, it modifies muscle tone and regulates postural reflexes. Through cerebellovestibulospinal and cerebelloreticulospinal, it facilitates gamma motor neurons in the spinal cord. This gamma motor neuron reflexly modify the activity of alpha motor neuron and regulate the muscle tone. Spinocerebellum is the site of alpha and gamma motor neurons linkage.
Control of voluntary movements. Corticocerebellum takes part in smooth performance of highly skilled voluntary movements. This is done with the help of two feedback loops. Open feedback loop, also called cerebro-cerebello-cerebral connection, which includes cerebro-ponto-cerebellar tract, which is formed by corticoponsine fibers, which ends in ipsilateral ponsine nuclei. Cerebellar fibers from the ponsine nuclei pass through middle cerebral peduncle of the opposite side and terminate in lateral zone of the cerebral hemisphere. Thus, whole pathway is called cerebello-ponto-cerebellar tract. Efferent go to cerebrum via dento-rubro-thalamic cortical tract, which consists of dentorubral fibers, which starts from the dentate nucleus and pass via superior cerebellar peduncle to end in red nucleus on the opposite side. Rubrothalamic fibers from red nucleus to thalamus and thalamocortical fibers from thalamus to area number 4 and 6 of the motor cortex. The cerebro-cerebello-cerebellar circuit modulates motor commands of pyramidal tract with a programming of movement. Closed feedback loop, it is formed by fibers from the cerebral motor cortex to the paravermal cerebellum and again back to the cerebral motor cortex. Afferent limb is formed by collaterals of corticospinal tract. It makes synapse with ipsilateral ponsine nuclei, inferior olivary nuclei, and contralateral reticular nuclei. Here, pontocerebellar fibers from ponsine nuclei and olivocerebellar fibers from inferior olivary nucleus reach the contralateral cerebral cortex, and reticulocerebellar fibers from lateral reticular nucleus are projected to ipsilateral cortex. All these fibers connected to the paravermal area of cerebellar hemisphere. and it also connected to the deep cerebellar nuclei, nucleus interpositus and nucleus dentatus. Efferent from dentate nucleus pass through superior cerebellar peduncle, cross the midline and divide into two groups. First is dentothalamic fibers, which reaches the motor cortex via thalamocortical fibers, and another one is the dentorubral fibers, which make synapse in the red nucleus of the opposite side. Rubrothalamic tract terminate in thalamus and reaches cerebral cortex via thalamocortical fibers. Rubroreticular tract terminate into reticular formation, which projects into spinal cord via reticulospinal tract. Rubrospinal tract, which directly projects from red nucleus to the spinal cord.
Comparator action. When motor cortex sends impulses to corticospinal tract, it also sends message to paravermal area of the cerebellum about the sequential intended plan of movement for the next fraction of a second. Here, cerebellum also gets feedback from the proprioceptors of muscle, tendons and joints about what actual movement is occurring. The paravermal area of the cerebellum compares the intended movement with the actual movement and sends corrective signals to the motor cortex through thalamus and red nucleus. This event is completed within 10 to 20 milliseconds. This is done by the closed loop circuit. Damping action. With its comparator function, cerebellum provides smooth coordination of agonist and antagonist muscle for the performance of acute purposeful movements. However, all the movements are pendular and have a tendency to overshoot. Corticocerebellum sends impulses to the cerebral cortex to discharge appropriate signals to the muscle so that extra exaggeration of muscle movements does not occur and prevents overshooting. So the movements will be smooth and coordinated. Planning of sequence of movements. Lateral parts of cerebral hemisphere communicate with premotor and sensory portion of the cerebral cortex. This is two-way communication between these two areas. Plan is transmitted from cerebral cortex to cerebellum, and there is a two-way traffic between two areas, which provides appropriate transmission from one movement to the next. This plan is stored as a memory in the cerebral cortex. Once the learning process is over, these activities are executed easily and smoothly in a sequence. Timing function. Lateral part of cerebellar hemisphere provides appropriate timing for each movements. Predictive events. Cerebellum have role in predictive events with the help of auditory and visual phenomena. Let's say, person can predict how rapidly he can approach the object. Control of ballistic movements. Rapid alternative movements which takes place in different parts of the body. For example, rapid supination and pronation of hands or just like dancing movements. Cerebellum coordinates the action of agonist and antagonist muscle of the body. Servo mechanism. Cerebellum plays an important role in learning of motor skills. Once the skill is learned, sequential movements could be executed without interruption. But when there is any disturbance in the movement, corticocerebellum immediately influences the cerebral cortex and correct the movement. This action of corticocerebellum is known as servo mechanism.